Okay, so what we measure in actual Doppler is the Doppler frequency, that is, what is the frequency or the speed or the repetition of the blood which being moved from one place to the other. So the Doppler frequency is measured as a direct measure of the velocity of the blood flow across the angle of the movement. So if the blood flow is very high, then the frequency is very high, the Doppler effect is very high. And if the beam is more aligned, that is in parallel line with the blood flow, then the most probably the frequency is very high. So these two things will be having a very high Doppler frequency. And very important with the actual angle of beam is very important, because the angle of beam always reflects the flow of direction or the graph which we get from the Doppler. See, if the blood is coming towards the probe and the angle is more parallel to it, this is the most parallel angle which we can see, about 30 or 45 degree, and here we will get the absolute frequency or the velocity of the blood being coming towards the probe A. If the probe B is focused, you can see that the angle is almost 75 to 80 degree, and usually that frequency or that amplitude of will be nullified and it is decreasing. And if you see in the C, it is almost neutral, it is almost absolutely 90 degrees, so the amplitude or the velocity coming towards is almost negligible. So whenever you measure when coming to the D probe, when it is going away, it will be coming as a negative one, similar to this one, the absolute negative format. So whenever you are probing a velocity across a chamber, if you are putting at the possible maximum parallel line, but absolute parallel line is not possible. If you put at least possible parallel line, maybe 20 degree, 30 degree, then you will get the absolute shift of frequency or coming frequency, the frequency with which the blood is flowing. Or if that matter, if you are measuring across a valve, then the gradient across the valve can be told absolutely. If you have the angle changes, the parameters which you are measuring will change, and the actual thing which you want to get, like the pulmonary hypertension, the TR velocity, aortic valve stenosis, aortic valve gradient, mitral valve regurgitation, mitral valve gradient, mitral valve aortic regurgitation, the pulmonary hypertension, PHD pressure of time, all these things will vary if the angle of the probe pointing towards the blood flow changes.